Hello everybody, Teagan here, and I want to thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. Tonight, I'm going to be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of March. We're going to be visiting deep sky objects like galaxies and nebulae and star clusters, all that you might find in the night sky in the month of March. We're also going to see what the moon and the planets are up to. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. Neptune is too close to the sun to be visible this month. Venus and Jupiter continue to shine in the evening twilight. The pair are just 30 arc seconds apart on the first, but will then rapidly separate. A thin new moon appears to the upper left of Jupiter very shortly after sunset on the 22nd, and then close to Venus on the 23rd and 24th. Mercury becomes visible after sunset on the 27th when it appears just to the right of Jupiter, but you'll need a clear view of the western horizon to see them both. Uranus may only be visible for the first 10 days of the month, and once the skies are dark, you'll only have about 30 minutes to an hour before its low altitude will make observation rather difficult. Mars remains visible throughout the evening with the nearly first quarter moon appearing west of the planet on March 27th and to the east the following night. Saturn returns to the pre-dawn sky around mid-month with the waning crescent moon to its lower right on March 19th. Lastly, the moon turns full in Leo on the 7th, and then new again on the 21st. Now for the next object on our tour, we're going to be traveling 610 light years towards the constellation of Cancer. We're going to check out Messier 44, the Beehive Cluster. Located roughly between Castor and Pollux in Gemini and Regulus in Leo, this night sky sight can be glimpsed with the naked eye under dark skies and, like the Pleiades, has been known since antiquity. Also like the Pleiades, this is one large cluster that may be best observed through binoculars rather than a telescope. Even 8x32 binoculars will show an elongated diamond shape with a close double on the northern tip. Taking a look with 10x50s will nicely enhance this cluster, with a multitude of stars becoming visible across about half of the field of view. Telescopically, a low magnification of around 30 times will show a large group of young blue-white stars, with a few older orange stars hiding amongst them. Whether you are a beginner amateur astronomer with very little equipment or a very advanced amateur astronomer, Messier 44 is a favorite amongst all of them. For this next Messier object, we're going to stay within the constellation of Cancer, Messier 67, another beautiful open cluster. Messier 67 shares Cancer with Messier 44, and although fainter than the Beehive Cluster, it's still detectable in regular 10x50 binoculars as a small, hazy patch. Telescopically, a low magnification of 35 times reveals a tight, compact cluster of hundreds of faint blue-white stars. Be sure to look out for its brightest member, a coppery-colored star on the northeastern edge of the cluster. Now, Messier 44, given its grandiose size and bright stars, is a favorite amongst astrophotographers as far as star clusters go. But the next object is a splendid target for astrophotographers and is a favorite amongst the beginning, intermediate, and advanced photographers. That's Messier 81 and Messier 82. This close pair of galaxies can fit within the same telescopic field of view at around 40 times magnification. Some texture is visible on Messier 82 with a small scope, while the spiral arms of M81 may also be faintly seen with averted vision. Now, as is the case with all galaxies, visually speaking, the darker the skies and the larger your telescope, the better the views. M81 and M82 are no different. A larger telescope under dark skies will present both of these galaxies as an extraordinary sight. Now, spring is best known for its galaxies, hence the nickname galaxy season, but that does not mean there aren't other objects in the night sky to view. For instance, NGC 3242, the ghost of Jupiter. The ghost of Jupiter is a planetary nebula so-called thanks to it having the same apparent diameter as Jupiter. A small telescope will show a bright bluish disk, while mid-sized telescopes will show the central star encircled by a ring. Using a narrowband filter visually may make this nebula a bit more apparent, and it's also visible through binoculars, but it kind of resembles a star. Finally, the last deep sky object on our list is not a nebula, nor a cluster or a galaxy, but rather a multiple star system, Algieba. Otherwise known as Gamma Leonis, this famous multiple star can be found in the sickle of Leo's head and shows two stars through almost any binoculars. However, almost any telescope will split the brightest star into two golden components of equal brightness. Most of us know that Messier and Alcor form the easiest double stars in the night sky, but this one provides great opportunity for beginners to test their skills and their equipment. With this double star, a magnification of around 100 times is recommended to split that second star into its two components. All right, so that is it for this episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. If you have personally seen or photographed any of these objects, please let us know in the comments. We would love to hear your stories. If you have any questions, also let us know in the comments and we will be more than happy to assist. Please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any future content on all things astronomy and astrophotography. Thank you so much and see you next time.